Welcome to Project Poldergeist, an ongoing series of animated videos that plumb the complexities of life below sea level. I'm Poldergeist, and I'll be your host as we peer beneath the surface in the Netherlands and other coastal regions. Because when it comes to water in the Dutch, there's a lot more going on than meets the eye. The Dutch have been gambling with the sea for centuries. The land winnings have been good, even if there were occasional busts. With storm surge barriers up their sleeves, it seemed like the game could go on forever. But there's a new game in town. Come here, big guy. If you like high-stakes gambling with a whole new level of risk, this game's exactly what you're looking for. Let's check out the Dutch gambling profile. What are their strengths? They have an integrated water defense system, a dedicated money stream, a fleet of world-class engineers, scientists, and architects, and a whole lot of attitude. We live in the safest delta on Earth. Our dikes will protect us. That attitude may not be a strength. What about their weaknesses? 26% of the country is below sea level. An additional 34% is vulnerable to river flooding. They're so confident in their technology, the public tends to forget about risk. And that's before we add in climate change. Scientists cannot rule out the possibility of 2 meters of sea level rise by 2100, or 5 meters by 2150. 5 meters. All eyes are on the Dutch as they place their bets. So, big guy, what's your wager? 1 million new housing units in 10 years, and we're going to build them in vulnerable areas, like here and here. Now that's what I call raising the stakes. Not just because they place even more people at risk. What they're really doing is raising the stakes against themselves. New developments limit their ability to adapt. They leave no room for higher and wider dikes. They crowd out space for storing excess water. If dikes fail in densely populated, low-lying areas, mass evacuation may not be possible, and buildings could be too low for heads to stay above water. What are the Dutch thinking? To understand, we'll have to peer beneath the surface. Remember Too Big to Fail? In 2008, American banks were teetering on the brink. One of them sank. The government bailed out the rest. They were too big to fail. What if too deep to fail is the new, unspoken Dutch gambling strategy? The more assets we put in risky areas, the more likely it is the government will protect us. It's the perfect bet. We're guaranteed to win. Okay, but how exactly will the government protect you? The current plan is to raise dikes in anticipation of 1 meter of sea level rise by 2100, and they're well behind schedule. They'll need something more drastic than that. Maybe they'll raise the stakes and build a monumental seawall in front of the Dutch coast. A string of interconnected barrier islands, new land winnings bustling with activity, fossil-fueled pumps at full throttle expelling the Rhine and the Maas into the North Sea. But won't the sea just sneak in around the German and Belgian coasts? Maybe, just maybe, without admitting it to themselves, the Dutch are betting on something else. Mega problems call for mega solutions. A Dutch oceanographer came up with an idea he calls NEED, the Northern European Enclosure Dam. He hopes we'll never need it. Imagine this, a dam that runs from France to England and from Scotland to Norway, enclosing the entire North Sea and the Baltic to boot. Fortress Europe. To build it requires all the sand the world uses in a year. All the sand! It's technically and financially feasible. Politically iffy, diplomatically dubious, ecologically disastrous, humanly bankrupt. Is this really the path the Dutch are on? Can they still retreat from too deep to fail thinking and place bets in safer locations? Here are some reasons to be hopeful. Research institutes and designers have added new strategy cards to the deck. The Delta Commissioner called for rules that make it difficult to place bets in vulnerable places. the government created a new cabinet post for housing and spatial planning and appointed a dapper gentleman who knows a thing or two about shoes, regardless of whether they're dry or wet. And families are thinking twice about where they want to live. Any way you look at it, climate change is in the cards, and there is a lot at stake. Will the Dutch play a winning hand? We'll be watching. I'm Poldergeist. You know where to find me. I'll be right here, peering beneath the surface. Because when it comes to water and the Dutch, there's more going on than meets the eye.